One day after the U.S. broke its record for most cases in a day, the country did it again. Officials reported more than 121,000 cases Thursday. On Wednesday, the U.S. became the first nation in the world to pass 100,000 cases in a 24-hour period. For more on this, we are joined by Dr. Bob Lahita. He's a professor of medicine at New York Medical College and chairman of medicine at St. Joseph University Hospital. All right, doctor, let us start in the country of Denmark, where a mutated strain of the coronavirus has been found in minks, like mink, the animal. And it's reported to be linked to hundreds of cases. What are the dangers of the virus mutating?
Well, Vlad, it's interesting that this was brought to my attention this morning because I have this paper in the journal Science from July, which describes the fact that the pandemic virus is mutating, and it was mutating in minks in Denmark. And apparently 12 people have gotten the virus from minks, and 17 million minks are going to be killed because of that. And what has happened is the mutation, if you'll allow me, is at the spike protein of the virus. I have here a little model of the virus, and these green things are the spike proteins. The spike proteins have mutated, and so the antibody that is directed against the spike proteins is different now. It's going to be more specific to this mutation. So we don't know what this has to do with humans at the time, but nobody's taking any chances, and the minks are going to be eliminated. It's unfortunate, and I guess there's going to be a run on mink coats going forward, but nevertheless, the mink population will be decimated.
So we don't know, or it hasn't happened yet, that this version of the virus has been transmitted to humans. I suppose, we expect a virus to mutate, but it's really if it can get into the human population that makes it particularly tricky. And I'm wondering what sort of impact that would have on the efforts to deliver a vaccine.
Well, because the spike protein, Anne-Marie, is going to be different in this new strain of coronavirus or COVID, the vaccine may not be protective for that particular strain, and that is the concern of scientists. And we have been discussing this, as I mentioned, since July, since a paper appeared in Science, where we said, wow, this is a natural model for the COVID-19 infection in animals. But as you know, certain animal strains can be infected, like bats and the pangolin in Southeast Asia. But the mink is something new, and we've looked at the minks, and we're very concerned that this new strain may pose a problem for humans going forward. That's why all the minks are being sacrificed.
So, Doctor, we know that Americans are feeling very anxious about both the pandemic and the outcome of the presidential election. The pandemic remains a very real story for millions of Americans. In fact, the president had suggested that once the election happened, we would stop, we being the media, would stop talking about the coronavirus. If anything, the coronavirus, as the number of infections continue to rise, we're going to be talking about it a whole lot more. And then we've got this election, which is stressing people out, Republicans and Democrats alike. What can people do to sort of relieve the stress? And relieving the stress, that means going beyond just like putting your phone down, which I know is hard for a lot of people.
Right. So actually, I've just been talking about this amongst our own patients. There's a very high incidence of post-traumatic stress disorder, which means something that's lingering. And it makes people who are isolated evoke certain manifestations, such as severe anxiety. Some people actually get very depressed. And in the extreme, people get suicidal and say, I can't take this anymore. So if you get to the point of severe depression and thoughts of suicide, you should seek professional help from either a psychologist or a psychiatrist. And believe me, they're out there and they're ready. They know that this is an ongoing and increasing problem. So I would say that physical activity, if you can do it safely with a mask on, and that means jogging, swimming, if you can do that, swimming without a mask, obviously, but having physical activity, exercise is very important. Meditation, extremely important. 2 hours of meditation a day, if you can do it, will really solve a lot. And then yoga, which is definitely, as we know, scientists, enhances immune function and makes people feel overall better. So those three little points are very, very important to keeping people sane. And right now, we have concerns that people are really becoming overstressed due to the presidential election, number one, and number two, COVID. And this has been going on for months, so it's nothing new. But the presidential election has brought things to the head right now, and it's a real problem.
Dr. Bob Lahita, thank you very much, Dr. Bob. I'm going to take some of that advice up. I've been going for runs, long runs, Anne-Marie and Dr. Bob. That even though I hate to run because I just hate physical exercise. I love my couch. But I've been trying to run a little bit more, you know, so that I can sort of take my mind away for the exercise is good, right, Dr. Bob?
It's excellent. That's the way to go. That's number one. And get outside of your apartment or your house. Get out there and breathe the fresh air. Bundle up if it's cold and run. And you don't have to wear a mask when you run because you're not going to encounter anybody on the run, presumably.
That's good. That's good. I go the other way. As you know, I'm all about virtual reality. So I go inward. And believe it or not, you can meditate.
If you follow Anne-Marie's Facebook, you will see her doing her virtual reality exercises.
And watch a good movie.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you so much, Dr. Bob.
You're welcome.